Hi, I'm Lauren Dunn, Senior Salesforce Evangelist here at DocuSign and Salesforce MVP. I'm joined today by Fred Wade, Director of Engineering, and we're going to talk about the Apex Toolkit. Thanks for joining me, Fred.
Of course, it's my pleasure.
So, Fred, we met last year at Dreamforce 2018. I love a good origin story. How did it come about? How did we create the Apex Toolkit?
So throughout my tenure at DocuSign, I've had the opportunity to speak very frequently with some of our customers and partners. I love talking tech with them. I love getting feedback on our products. One of the common things, questions we heard were, why can't DocuSign for Salesforce do this? Why can't I integrate e-signature into Process Builder, for example? Or why can't I keep signature within my customer community? And to be honest, we didn't really have great answers for this. With the launch of Salesforce Essentials in 2018, we recognized an opportunity to streamline and simplify our e-signature process. And in that process, we created the Apex Toolkit. So we built a clean object model and ported over our code from the older product. We slapped the global modifier on some of our key classes, and we built a very modern lightning-first native UI on top of that, proving that we could build a fully functional e-signature solution on top of the Apex Toolkit. And now we're offering that to the rest of our friends, our developers.
What different actions can be invoked within the Apex Toolkit? What can we do with it?
Yeah, so the Apex Toolkit is primarily an e-signature solution. So sending envelopes, retrieving envelope status. That's kind of our bread and butter with the Apex Toolkit. There are also some interesting use cases that we enable through the Apex Toolkit that are not available in our prepackaged Salesforce solutions. So for example, bulk sending envelopes. Send a copy of an envelope to a mailing list. Think sending a permission slip to a group of parents for a field trip. Or maybe something like embedded signing. So keeping your customers or partners within your community and allowing them to sign documents from within that community.
Yep, that's a big one. So it's my favorite time of year. Dreamforce 2019 is next week. Do we have any sneak peeks that we can share?
Sure. Very quick sneak peek. So we have something we're calling envelope multi-send, which is distinct from our bulk sending. The difference is you can send arbitrary envelopes to a list of recipients in a single Apex transaction, something our customers have asked for time and time again. We'll be talking a lot more about this at our breakout sessions at Dreamforce. So definitely come visit us and check out our sessions.
Yeah, can't wait. So you've talked about it. Can I see it? Will you give us a demo?
Absolutely. It'd be my pleasure.
Awesome.
So I've already installed the Apex Toolkit into my Salesforce org here. So the first thing I'm going to do is log into my DocuSign Developer Sandbox. And I'm going to complete the OAuth flow here. And once this is complete, I'm ready to start coding. So I'm going to select my account. And now I am good to go. So for this demonstration, I created a contact, creatively named Apex Toolkit. And on this contact, I attached a simple agreement, again, just for demonstration purposes. I want to send this to my contact.
Cool.
Okay. So I'm going to switch over to Developer Console here, and I've already put together the code here, but I'll walk through each step. So I'm going to pass in my contact ID that I just showed you, and I'm going to let the Apex Toolkit do all the heavy lifting. So first thing I'm going to do is get an empty envelope and link it to my contact. Next, I'm going to add documents that are linked to my contact. Again, you can see here that I'm not actually passing in a specific agreement ID or anything like that. I'm going to add recipients. In this case, it's, again, pointing to the contact, so it's going to pull the contact details mm-hmm. and send it to them. And I'm going to set the email subject and message that I want to send. Next thing I'm going to do is just call this method here called sendEnvelope. And I'm going to say send it now, instead of creating a draft. And then I'm going to print out the result of that, which is the DocuSign assigned envelope ID. And then I'm going to request status for my contact. And any envelopes attached to that contact record will come back here. In this case, I'm only asking for one in the first one. And then I'm going to print out what the status was returned by the DocuSign API. So let's see how that works. Okay, let me try that again. So I'm just going to call my test method here, again, just passing in the contact ID that I created previously. Mm-hmm. Let's let the gears turn a little bit.
I'm excited.
And here we go. We can see the log output that I specified, which is the DocuSign envelope ID, and the status of the envelope, which is sent, which is exactly what I would hope. Then we go to my inbox here, and I can see that I already received the email, and it has my subject that I specified, plus the message I specified, and I can go ahead and go through the DocuSign signing experience that we all know and love.
Awesome, thank you. Mm-hmm. So where can our audience go to access all the Apex Toolkit?
So I'd recommend you go to our Developer Center. You can go to developers.docusign.com/salesforce. There we have complete reference documentation for the Apex Toolkit, as well as instructions on how to install it, coding guides, and some code examples.
So for developers facing trouble with Apex Toolkit or, you know, getting off the ground, where can they go to get some help?
Yeah, so I think the first stop should be Stack Overflow. That's where you get the quickest response. Just make sure to tag your questions with DocuSign API. We're also hosting a webinar on December 5th for the Apex Toolkit, and the link to that webinar for registration will be in our video's description.
I'm so excited to get started with the Apex Toolkit. Thank you so much, Fred, for sharing this amazing content. If you're ready to get going on the Apex Toolkit, please check out the documentation on our developer website. The link is below in the description. Please join us next month for the next Developer Deep Dive.
If you liked that video, be sure to subscribe to our channel for the latest DocuSign developer content. If you want to see a specific topic in a future video, comment below. For everything else, visit the DocuSign Developer Center.